this stage, the usual protocol is that aircrew go to their designated hotel, depending on where the airline takes them. And there are 25 or 26 different hotels where the aircrew are located, which makes it very difficult to police. From Tuesday, I can confirm, given the good work the Minister for Health has done with his colleagues, as have the New South Wales Police, that from Tuesday there'll be two designated hotels for all aircrew. It does put pressure on those airlines and those aircrew, but we have to consider the right balance. So from Tuesday they'll all be designated in two police hotel quarantines as opposed to 25 or 26, which will mean that they will be better compliant. So can I also stress the issue isn't the guidelines we have in place. It's unfortunately a few occasions when people breach the guidelines or actually chose not to self-isolate when they should have. I want to make that very clear. The systems themselves haven't been the challenge, but it's been people disobeying what's in place. From Tuesday, there'll be no chance of disobedience given the police and health will be ensuring that they are located at two places close to the airport as opposed to a wide range or ride number.
Just to clarify that with this
avalanche. No, no. Can I make it clear? And Dr. Chant made it clear. We do not yet know the exact. We know it's an international strain, potentially strong links to the US, but we don't know exactly what overseas traveller was the person that's the cause of that. And Dr. Chance made that clear. But we have had previous cases which have been related, the transport worker, for example. So can I just stress, that it's not the systems we have in place at the moment, but unfortunately the lack of compliance. But from Tuesday, that door will also be shut because police will be able to literally police those two hotel quarantines. Well, yes, although they have different rules because they're in transit. They don't have to stay. They're actually able to be in isolation until they have to get on the next flight back to their job. So obviously, if you mandated 14-day quarantine, you wouldn't be accepting any flights and Aussies wouldn't be able to come home. And that's the balance we have to wear. But I think that's a good reminder to all Australians about the burden New South Wales is wearing. We've said all along that it's a huge risk for us, but it's a risk we take because we want Australians to come back home, and we also, as the Minister said, want freight to come back. But I want to commend the Minister for Health for the work he's done, our health officials, but also the New South Wales Police, who'll be able to stand up the new arrangements from Tuesday.
Premier, what does it currently look like, just to the public who don't understand where these aircrew are going at the moment? They're coming in from a flight from the United States. What happens? There's 25 hotels. Are those police? Do they have police there? Is it the airlines who police it?
Yeah, at the moment, that's obviously up to the airlines and the aircrew themselves to maintain their self-isolation. And in order to close that door, we are saying to them from Tuesday, our New South Wales Police will actually be enforcing compliance. We've given the next few days to adjust and get everybody used to it. It's a massive operation. And as the Minister for Health knows, every airline has had different policies. But now to close that door, from Tuesday, they'll all be required to go to one of two hotels, which the police will be able to monitor to make sure that everybody is actually respecting the guidelines. And I want to stress, it's the breach of the guidelines that's the problem. It's not the actual guidelines themselves. It's people, unfortunately, doing the wrong thing. And we can't risk that because we know also that in addition to the number of people that are coming back home, the infection rates in Europe, in North America, are actually going through the roof. And as you noticed, before the outbreak we had in Avalon, the number of cases overnight from quarantine was going up because of the nature in which the infection's increasing overseas. And that obviously has an impact on the aircrew as well.
Premier, at the moment you've got